Loving and gracious God, I can thank you again that you have called me here, have me, to be the shepherd of this flock. I thank you for that honor, Lord. And Lord, I pray that as I stand here every Sunday morning, that you would speak through me or in spite of me. Lord, I pray that the meditations of my heart, mind, and spirit are pleasing to you. For you are my rock, you are my redeemer, you are my great God, and you are my best friend. Amen. I would ask that you would stand for the reading of the Gospel according to Mark. We are reading verses 5. 21 through Mark 5, sorry, verses 21 through 34. Listen to and for a word from God to his healing home, the church. After Jesus returned across the sea, a large crowd quickly followed him. So he stayed by the sea. One of the leaders of the synagogue, a man named Jairus, came and fell at his feet, begging him to heal his daughter. My daughter is dying, and she's only 12 years old. Please come to my house. Just place your hands on her. I know that if you do, she will live. Jesus began traveling with Jairus toward his home. The crowd was pressing around Jesus. There was a woman who had suffered continuous bleeding for 12 years, bleeding that made her ritually unclean and an outcast according to the purity laws. She had suffered greatly, and although she spent all her money on her medical care, she had only gotten worse. She had heard of this miracle worker, this miracle man, Jesus. She snuck in behind him in the crowd and reached out her hand to touch his cloak. Even if all I touch are his clothes, I know I will be healed. As soon as her fingers brushed his cloak, the bleeding stopped. She could feel that she was whole again. Lots of people were pressed against Jesus at that moment, but he immediately felt her touch. He felt healing power flow out of him. He stopped. Everyone stopped. He looked around. Who just touched my robe? His disciples broke the uneasy silence. Jesus, the crowd is so thick that everyone is touching you. Why do you ask who touched him? But Jesus waited. His gaze swept across the crowd to see who had done it. At last, the woman, knowing he was talking about her, pushed forward and dropped to her knees. She was shaking with fear and amazement. I touched you. Then she told Jesus the reason why. Jesus listened to her story. Daughter, you won't fall because you dared to believe. Go in peace and stay well. The word of God for you and me, the children of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. Please be seated. I know that I'm not supposed to be here, she thought to herself. But that miracle worker, that Jesus person, is due to come by soon. I hope no one sees me. If they do, it could be the end of my life. But then again, I would rather be dead than to suffer any more from this condition I have. Nothing has worked. I have no more money. I can't even go home to see my children and family. I wonder how big they must be now. They are 12 years older. I wonder if they even remember me. This has got to work. I know he has healed so many people. I know what I'll do. I will sneak in the back and work my way forward. I only need to just brush his cloak, and I will be healed. Maybe no one will see me, and then I can just sneak away afterwards. I have to try. This being an outcast is killing me. I only want to be healed and go home where I belong. Oh God, please let this work. I have nothing else to lose. Okay, here he comes. Now let me just reach through and touch his robe just a little bit further. A little bit further. There, I touched it. Wait, it stopped. I don't feel a hemorrhage anymore. I haven't felt this good in years. The man must be truth. I just hope he doesn't take away my healing. That's your Bible, isn't it? Good morning. Sorry, come on, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you, and I'm just walking you out there. Happy first day of year six for me. This is actually my first day of my sixth year being your pastor. It is so awesome. I'm so glad. I am so, so glad to be here with you. We have so much to do for the kingdom together. And I know that we are going to be ready to take on anything that God has us to do.
It's always an if, isn't it?
If
we are willing.
So the past few weeks, we've been hearing about how God wants us to be with each other and with the world. We have talked about how we have a good, good Father who loves us with an unquenchable love. No matter what we do, we can't change that. We can't change His love for us. We can't be too bad. We can't be too good. We can't change the fact that He loves us. I like that.
I like that promise. Amen.
It has nothing to do with us, but everything to do with His grace. We can't earn it. It just is. We've also talked about how there are times that we unfortunately don't get along with our brothers and sisters. How it must break Dad's heart when we decide to be divided instead of one body in Christ. My challenge question this week is this. Can Jesus heal? Can he?
Yes.
Are you sure about that?
Yes.
Okay. So if he can, are we sharing that healing with others?
Yes.
Who said yes?
I did.
You did. I know you did. He walked around town with his Bible. Do you know Jesus? I know he does. Yes, he does. Thank you for that. All right. Do we believe He is here to heal all the broken or just a few? Are you sure about that?
Yes.
We have to include everybody in this whole thing? This all? I'm not sure about this. Okay, are we making it a select few? And Jesus is telling us to open our hearts and our lives to others on the fringe of society. Sure about that? She's a PK. Are you sure about that? You're positive about that. The woman in the Mark that I read this morning, she was willing to pay any price just to touch the hem of Jesus' robe. Now, this woman was called unclean because of her medical condition. She had no business being around people because of this condition. Now, she's had this condition for 12 years, and she probably had no contact with others in 12 years. She is probably, could have been even stoned for touching someone. Think about it. She was unclean, not even be around anyone. She was on the outskirts. But she knew that if she could just touch that robe, just the edge of that robe, she would be healed. And it was worth it, even though the encounter could have cost her very life. The scripture tells us, Jesus, when the disciples are talking, Jesus, the crowd is so thick that everyone is touching you. Why do you ask who touched me? But Jesus waited. His gaze looked across the crowd to see who had done it. At last, the woman, knowing he was talking about her, pushed forward and dropped to her knees. She was shaking with fear and amazement, and she said to him, I touched you. Then she told him the reason why, and Jesus said to her, Daughter, you are well because you dared to believe. Go in peace. She had faith. She believed. And she was healed. Now, there are many unclean souls out there, so to speak, right? That are in need of the healing balm of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Well, guess what? We are called to be, we need to be that hem of Jesus. We need to be that healing balm of Jesus. We need to be the tassels on his robe. Because we need to bring others to the one who gives life. The tangible for the intangible. Tangible, the definition of tangible is easily seen or recognized, able to touch or felt. When we are radically loving others, Jesus is recognized within us. We become the hand, the feet, the voice of Jesus in the world. We are the tangible touch that heals. Sort of like the woman who touched Jesus' robe, just the hem, and she was healed. We too can be that hem of Jesus. Now you may be saying, how the heck can we be the hem of Jesus? We are not Jesus. I have got a demonstration, a mental image, a visual image for you. We did this yesterday, and we did this for the image yesterday. So, you know, of course, we, you know, Jared and Kristen. But you see, we are here, and Jesus is here. Now, when we accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior, Jesus comes and we come together and we live in him and he lives in us. Jesus heals in and through our voices, our hands, our feet, our lives, our image, our touch. Jesus within us heals. How's that for demonstration? You guys get it now? You get it? It's not us who's doing the healing, it's Jesus doing the healing in and through us. And we are united in Christ. Not just Christ, but we are united with each other because we are all united in Christ. We all have Christ living in us. We all deserve the same chance. So my question to you, you and I, is this morning. How much does Jesus really matter? What does he mean to you and I? Is Jesus worth the price? Is he? If he is worth the price, and worth more than anything, are you and I keeping it to ourselves, or are we sharing the wealth we have in Jesus? Are we keeping those who need healing away from the master physician, or are we making a doctor's appointment for them? Things to ponder.